into the ring. Welcome to Post Orange versus Saginaw Valley. My name is Frisco, and we're going to get right into it. Starting off with Lone Wolf on Wii Fit Trainer versus Pyramithra. Now, I can't say, you don't see many Wii Fits around. I don't necessarily know how well they do against characters like Pyra and Mithra. Mithra's probably a pretty favorable matchup, not going to lie. Though I can't imagine side B from Pyra being a little annoying against Wii Fit's ball. But I think the frame data on Wii Fit, it can be kind of comparable in some ways to like the combo potential that Pyramithra has. Though that foresight's going to get triggered right off the bat. Going to get a little bit of percent on. These dash attacks coming out of Lone Wolf's Wii Fit have been pretty great right now, actually. A little bit of deep breathing. You don't want to be above Mithra. She's also combo you right for days. The very start, when Mithra first came out, Photon Edge was the most annoying move I ever had to deal with for a long time. Ooh, but, oh my god, Prominence Revolt is so strong, able to kill right off the top in those instances. That, gonna trade dash attacks right there. Oh, reading the shield, going for the grab. And these side Bs are doing a little bit of work right now for Pyramithra. I'd probably like to see a few more Nair approaches coming out from Lone Wolf right now. Though, I will say, these dash attacks are doing a good chunk of work. Ball right off the edge, tried and true. I'm gonna catch the jump from ledge with the side B. Good recovery low. Good stall at the ledge. I'm actually surprised that doesn't hit Wii Fit Trainer's ledge hang. Gonna shoot right through that side B again. Promise Roll is not quite gonna take it. That move kills way earlier than I think it really should. Oh, the air dodge. Very unfortunate stuff coming out. Leaving Lone Wolf at his last stock right now. Can Lone Wolf secure against this Mithra right now? F they're off stage. Interrupting the side B with dash attack. That's not going to probably be a punish. That move, that F smash on Mithra is kind of hard to punish sometimes. It's kind of surprising. Just because it's so big. Very nice up smash. Going to take this stock. Good dash attack. I'm pretty sure that was a weird confirm. Not quite a punish. Now, with Wii Fit, I would try my best to keep a little bit of distance and kind of zone out a little bit with ball and whatnot. Especially against a character like Pyra, whose mobility isn't the most fantastic. At least very lacking in comparison to Mithra. Plus, you can punish these big F smashes on Pyra a little bit easier than you can on Mithra. Yeah. Comes a little tough right here. Oh, and that's going to anti-air the approach with that F smash. Bringing Post down to 6 stocks and Saginaw to 8. Good stuff coming out of Saginaw right off the bat. Now, Pyramithra's characters, you know, they're pretty much the meta in a lot of ways right now. So they're going to do very well against a wide variety of characters in the lineup. So it's one of those things where, you know, you kind of need to be careful. You don't want to bring in a character that can, you know, be overwhelmed by Mithra's, like, oppressive neutral. I actually might opt for Terry in the lineup against Pyramithra. Terry has pretty wonderful mobility in that regard. He can probably compete with Mithra to some extent, even though he's not quite as fast, but he can mix up his approaches in many great ways. And since this is an ECAC match, now we have the following stage list in front of us. Against characters like Pyra and Mithra, it's kind of hard to say because they do get decent up air strings. But I don't know if they necessarily get a ton off a middle platform on a triplat. I might bring them to a triplat, though you do need to be careful if Pyra tries to prominence revolt onto the top platform, because that's going to be a super early kill. But as long as you avoid those situations, you should be fine, I believe, on a triplat. Otherwise, if you're going to play a zoner, definitely make it a more wide stage, so you have a bit more room to work with. And we're going to get the Mario coming for Lily here. So Lily's going to be the next to take on this Pyramithra. Mario's not a bad pick, and I feel like Mario has a lot to actually kind of negate Pyramithra's recovery, because that's the one weakness Pyramithra has is, you know, their recovery can be a little suspect. Their up B, their low up Bs can be kind of exploitable. Mithra's side B to ledge, especially Mario, can be very oppressive on that. Though Mario does struggle a lot with, you know, Sorries. He does not like fighting characters that have big disjoints, though he can do well against them. Very nice up throw into down air. We gotta be aware of those side Bs. This Miss Mithra definitely likes throwing out those side Bs in neutral, which is not the greatest thing if you know how to punish it, but it can be annoying to deal with. The back hit of Prominence Revolt is a lot weaker than the strong hit. It's kind of hilarious, to be honest. Nice up air strings. Trying to go for the spike on the fair, but missing. That's gonna be a punish. Down throw. Not able to get a follow up off of it, though. Nair's going to detect situation on the platform. If you had to be anywhere, if you had to be in any sort of position against Pyramitha, try and stay below them. Ooh, really nice drop shield in the F smash. I didn't think you could get away with that, to be honest. Now again, same exact punish, just in the opposite direction. Oh, that... They held down! Wow! They held down and missed the platform, missed the ledge completely. If you hold down when you're anywhere near the ledge, you go straight down. Nice high recovery against Pyra side B. I actually really like the idea of that run up and grab, but it was just a little too early. It was a very good mix-up. Not able to punish that right now. Another platform situation. F-tilt is not going to be big enough to punish that. Nice little recovery. Going up for the run up grab. Very nice F-smash to interrupt right there. And these down airs are actually doing a lot of work for Lily right now. I'm really liking these down airs on approach. A little bit of a fireball to cover ledge. And that side B is going to cover neutral getup. That side B is very tough to kind of time, because you either want to ledge hang, or you want to time your neutral getup so that it's at the very end of the side B's active hitbox. Ooh, gonna interrupt the dash attack, but not able to punish from there. In those situations, you might want to roll, because Pyra can't do a ton from that side B. She can only jump and footstool you and air dodge. She can't actually attack you while that sword is out. So you might as well approach her in those situations. I like these fireballs to cover the approach. Good down air again on the cross-up. The back hit of down air is going to send right up, and that's going to put Lily at her last stock. At their last stock. Photon Edge. Tried and true. Side B is doing so much work. That move can be safe if it's at the very edge of the hit. So it's very hard to punish sometimes. But if they do it right on your shield, then it's pretty easy to punish. Now, with a lot of these blazing ends... Very nice wait. With a lot of these blazing ends, you kind of want to bide your time. Here's not going to be another one. Oh, no, they're going to go for a dash attack. You want to try and not have to shield it. You want to see if you can kind of lure them to throw that out and then go for something like a jump right over or something. Because it's not like Pyra can actually interrupt your jump. She just can only air dodge through you. Very nice cape. Oh, that smash is going to be in the wrong way. We're going to start seeing some desperation moves coming out from both characters right now in Hypersense. You could probably cape that. Nice up air as a punish. I like the patience coming out of Lily right now. There, that could be a punish. Yeah, that move has no right hitting below ledge like that. Oh, F tilt. So big. Yeah, jump was burned. And that brings Post down to their last three stocks. And Saginaw at 7. Power the Aegis. So, I believe Crimson Vexus is going to be coming out at this point. I think so. It would make sense. And I think Terry is going to do a lot of work in this matchup. Personally, I think Terry can do a decent job spiking Pyramithra's recovery when they're off ledge. Terry's neutral with Power Wave can probably interrupt a lot of the side B approaches if you're timing it correctly. But you also don't want to get caught in Power Wave when they're immediately throwing it out, you know? But he also has a lot of invincible limbs on his attack. So I think it could be relatively even, though I also can foresee Terry struggling a little bit off stage against Pyra and whatnot. And they have a lot of two framing options when it comes to like that side B, the down air. And the down air is pretty big. It's probably a little tough for Terry to recover. But he has enough of a mix up, I think, in order for it to work out. And here comes Crimson Vexus with the Terry. Now, I think this last stock is imperative to clean up the last stock so you at least get the second person in the rotation to understand what you're going up against. One, go! And then we're going to see the RSDs. Hey, come on! I like Terry a lot. He's probably my favorite FGC character in the game. Oh, I'm gonna go for the down tilts and the power dunk. Which is what I'm saying. Terry's like mobility is really useful in these matchups, and he can punish pretty decently on a shield. It's really a lot harder for Pyramithra to cross up Terry. Nice crack shoot. I like these up smashes. And hold on edge. Wow, that was a really. What percent was she at? Whoa, well, she was 109. Okay. I thought she was in a much lower percent. But that last stock is going to go to Terry. And we are going to see the second player coming out of Saginaw. And Saginaw down to 6. Very good showing coming out of Crimson. So here we have the ECAC stage list again. Now, with Post banning right now, and with Terry, I don't know, Terry's a pretty versatile character. He can, you know, work very well in a lot of conditions because he has auto turnaround on the ground. He gets a lot of benefit when people try to approach him and try to cross up his shield on the ground. So even stages like FD work very well for him, just because of his turnaround mechanic and whatnot, and his ability to kind of cancel into all of these combos. But he also has a lot going for him on triplats because he can kill off the top with his up B if he has the right sort of strings going. I don't think Terry necessarily has a bad stage. Though if you predict your opponent might send out a zoner, you may want to ban stages like Kalos. You may want to ban stages Town and City is kind of like an FD, but you know, they can have platform formations that can be more inducive to a zoner. You probably want to ban Kalos at the very least. Maybe I feel like Terry works well on Yoshi's story, so I'd probably ban Kalos and maybe one of the dual plats. I don't know. I feel like Terry just generally gets a lot of benefit out of a lot of these stages. I guess you could ban FD if you really think you're going to get zoned out, but I do think FD is also great for him. It's tough. I think he's such a great character. I put Terry pretty highly. I think he's a very strong character in this game. I think he can do a lot against a lot of the very meta characters, you know? Because if you're an FGC character, you have such good close range potential Plus, you have amazing mobility. Whereas there's other characters that don't have such great mobility that are FGC kind of type fighters, like your Kazuya's, which I know Kazuya is kind of considered like potentially top tier, but he has a lot of movement problems sometimes. Like, he can get kind of like, it can be very volatile in certain matchups for him. And characters like Ryu, who do have some mobility options, but it's not nearly as good as Ken. I tend to put Ken and Terry in pretty high regard in this game. And Kazuya, for, you know, Kazuya has the cheese, so he can potentially just delete stocks at whatever percent he wants. And we're going to get Terry versus Steve. Now, I think this is my first time seeing a Steve in these crew battle formats when it comes to the ECAC or NECC matches. So this is going to be very interesting. It's going to be a straight, right off the start match. No need to take stocks. Now, a lot of people have a lot of debate on how to actually fight Steve in this game. Because a lot of people says, oh, you have to prevent him from mining. You got to get in as quick as possible. Whereas other characters, I think, get good benefit trying to zone him out and kind of ignoring the fact that he gets diamond. But it kind of depends. I know with Terry, you need to, like, kind of, you know, get in on him because that's all Terry really has. Recovering a little low right there. But you need to really mix up your movement when fighting a character like Steve. Sending him right on the TNT. That was so good. Oh, that's a lot of damage, man. Here's the thing. Is that if you're Terry, you don't want to be running in and dashing attacking right off. Because Steve's love to back off. They love to back off and punish your approach. So you generally... I feel like in this matchup, you're going to have a lot more benefit using things like Power Dunk. Kind of coming in at that angle. Very good. And that's going to take the stock for Crimson right now. Very good showing coming out of Crimson right now. Oh, that's going to be a punish. With Go Meter online, you can probably get a good chunk going right here. First, you got to get in on Steve, and that's kind of tough. That can be a punish. I can't believe he had enough time to block it. And that's another thing. You when minecart comes around, you need an answer to that. And you as Terry, you could probably answer with that with aerial neutral B. I don't think you maybe you can tank with it with Nair. Probably F tilt. I'm sorry, forward air. Or power dunk. It's kind of tough. You at least need to spot dodge through it or roll through it. With Terry at 0%, though, this is looking pretty good for Crimson right now. I like these down tilts at ledge. Dash attack is not quite strong enough to take it against Steve. But put Steve in a really tough position, and Minecart is gonna rack up some decent damage. That was a spike hit, but it bounced at such a weird angle. It was so cool. I love Terry so much. The jab combos. Walking jabs. Gonna punish that with a back throw. Crimson needs to take the stock now. He needs to make sure he does not lose this stock right now. I do like these. That was actually really decent F-smash. F-smash colliding with Cart. Gonna punish these F-smashes and racking up damage. Almost lapping the stocks again. Lapping percentage, rather. He's making these F-smashes on Cart really work. It's kind of funny. Oh, you gotta be careful, though. Does Steve have diamond? No, he doesn't have diamond. This is really great for Terry right now, because Steve hasn't had a chance to get diamond. He is gonna get gold, though, and gold is a very good substitute for diamond. It's a little weaker, but it's a lot faster. Oh, we got diamond on deck. Oh, there's gonna be a dash attack. Gonna take that stock, leaving Crimson Vexus on his last one. Up smash is going to take it on Steve, putting Terry down to his last stock, so now Post is down to one. And Saginaw is on their last three stocks, which is a very key point in the match, because now we have the full lineup coming out of Saginaw right now. Unless we do a character switch, we see one coming from Saginaw, everything's on the table. We see all the potential characters right now. I think he really made Hollow Bastion work well for him. I wouldn't mind going to see Terry go back on Hollow Bastion. I wouldn't mind it at all. And considering Post is kind of going in a little blind right now, we don't know who the last character is right now. It's kind of hard to make bans, especially for a character like Terry. I feel like Terry just generally wants to ban what his opponent doesn't like, versus trying to get stages that he does like, you know. Because Terry just is a very versatile character. He can work on whatever. So this is kind of the thing. Terry needs to try and take a guess at who they might send out. And out of a roster of 80 plus characters, that's kind of tough. It's pretty tough. You could always make an assumption that it's going to go for like a top tier character, such as like Pyramithra, where they might like that middle platform. Maybe ban Smashville. Maybe ban Hollow Bastion. Because they generally would probably like those stages. Having a big platform is probably really great for them. It's going to be Piranha Plant. This is a matchup you don't see terribly often. Now, I think Piranha Plant is such a funny character. He's just so funny. With Patui. Patui is like one of the most degenerate moves in this game, and I love it. I think Patui is a very unique move, to be honest. And Piranha Plant does well with it. But Piranha Plant definitely has a lot of flaws, where he is amazing at ledge trapping, but his general neutral is not amazing. Though the armor on that down B is going to be pretty useful, I would say, in this matchup against Terry. Probably wants to use that pretty often. And considering Terry wants to be in on Piranha Plant at all times, Terry needs to be very careful with how he lands, because he can very easily, you know, hit Piranha Plant and then get punished on hit by Patui. And that's going to be another thing. You do not want to be charging preemptively against Piranha Plant, because he can always just send Patui right at you. Power Dunk's just going to miss that. Nair. I kind of want to see Terry go for Nairs or timing Power Dunks to get the spike on Piranha Plant's recovery. I mean, when I say Nair, I mean Dare. That could be a punish at ledge. When Piranha Plant regrabs, I'm pretty sure Terry can down tilt in 2 frames. I could be wrong. I could always be wrong. Nice down smash. He's going to steal at the stock, leaving Saginaw at their last 2 stocks with this match. And that armor is going to go right through the side B. Oh, really nice avoiding the down B right there. Just attack. Attack ledge. Oh, going for a roll. Oh, very nice air dodge. Oh, I'm going to cut. By the down B. Nice power wave. Are you okay? Really good Buster Wolf. Not quite strong enough, though. That could have killed with some more suspect DI. Power Gazer. That crack shoot was really good air dodge. Living on those stocks. That could be a punish. I'm pretty sure, yeah. When he regrabs, you could punish with like Power Gazer or something like that. Net up smash was a little greedy. Oh! And wow, Saginaw's Piranha Plant is going to SD on that, though. Oh, very good avoiding the Patui. Very good Power Gazer, reading the jump. And here's the part where Terry can steal stocks, but Crimson needs to be careful here. Oh, nice air dodge through the F smash. Keep your distance. Nice. Oh, jabbing Power Gazer. Not the right percents. Very good Buster Wolf, 59%. This could very well be in Crimson's favor right now. Oh, that shield is looking like a skill. Don't shield again. Don't shield again. Don't shield again. Very good power down gate, 84%. This is a lot of rage on Terry, too. This could very... Oh, my God. Wow. Wonderful S match. And Post is going to steal that. Post is going to win the first match of... Wow. Going to win match number one. That's crazy. And now we go back to 9-on-9 right now. That's nuts. I can't... Wonderful job to Crimson for stealing that. Wow. That was great. From a... My God. How big was the stock deficit? It was like a 4-stock deficit, I think. Because down to... Crimson was down to his last 3. No, a 3-stock deficit. There was a 3-stock deficit. And a pretty big turnaround coming for Post. That was crazy. Very good stuff coming out of Crimson. Really showing that, you know, Saginaw had a very good start. But, you know, Terry's a really good anchor. That That's crazy. And so now we start the match. Oh, we start the round over again, where we have our picks from the starter stages. Counter picks do not come into play until after the first match of the second round. So for this match we're going into, we're either going to see Battlefield, Final Destination, Town and City, Pokemon Stadium 2, or Smashville. We're not going to see counter picks. We're not going to see the counter picks until match number 2. So this could go either way. This is as close as it gets, guys. Now, for the starting match, you possibly want to switch it around a little bit if you want to get, like, a stronger start. Though, I don't know. If Post clutched it out in the end, I don't know how much I would actually change, to be honest. I mean, if Lone Wolf starts again, he could always go as K-Rool. I know he has a K-Rool. But right now, I know he's really wanting to get the Wii Fit down. So, I don't know. I wouldn't necessarily switch off Wii Fit. You could change a few things. Maybe throw a bit more side B in your neutral. A bit more neutral air in general for your combo follow-ups up from there. Things of that sort. You could probably approach your neutral a little differently. Charge a bit more neutral B at the side of the stage. A little bit less dash attack. Though the dash attack did work well for Lone Wolf in that first match. It was just about, like, kind of cleaning up the stock. He was able to get the percentage and get the punish landings. But a lot of the stock wasn't able to kind of, like, seal the deal, you know? My cat wants in on the fun. Kitty. Hi, Denny. That's actually a really cool emote. I like that emote. It kind of looks like my cat, too, a little bit. I need to buy you shades, you know. I also like Saginaw's tag for SV Sad Boy. I like it. Sad Boys for life, bro. We're gonna get Mario versus Piranha Plant. Oh, geez. This is the canon matchup, I guess. So, Mario probably does extremely well in this matchup. Piranha Plant's a pretty heavy character. Pretty big combo food. Mario has Cape to reflect Patooie. And I think he can also reflect the Poison Cloud, which is kind of a fun fact, I think. I'm pretty sure he can do that. Oh, gonna get... Oh, punish that jump with a side, with that down B. Jumping right over that F smash. And here's the thing. If Piranha Plant is able to zone, it can be a little tough to get in on him sometimes. Punishing that charge F smash with the dash attack. Against a character like this, I definitely want to see Mario throw out a bit more fireball. That was so close to a spike! I'm pretty sure he could have survived that, but it would have been so cool. I wanted to see the spike. That's good. Yep, good grab out of shield. Ooh, interesting F smash. Like that back air into... Ooh, back air into F tilt. I like it. Ooh. Up B's gonna punish that approach. Poison Cloud, you do not want to shield Poison Cloud. You'll get stuck right in there. I like the attempt at the fair off stage. It's not a bad choice against Piranha Plant. Though you have to be a little wary about the leaves on the side of Piranha Plant's up B. It can interrupt a lot of what Mario kind of wants to do, because it is a disjoint. That F smash is not quite strong enough, but it is going to put Piranha Plant in a really kind of tough position. Oh, but that F smash is going to get punished by that down B. This Piranha Plant does like to be a little aggressive off the stage. You probably want to bide your time a little bit. Yep, that is a down B. That is the tried and true. Oh, down B's going to punish that approach. Dash attack going to catch that landing. Oh, here comes the... When Piranha Plant be zoning, it's kind of tough. Because if you're chasing Piranha Plant, you're going to get caught in a lot of these traps. I kind of want to see up smash, because he definitely likes to roll if he's not being aggressive. So I would like to see Mario do up smash a bit more instead of going to these F smashes, because up smash covers a bigger range overall, and it can kill off the top at any point on the stage. I like these attempts, though, off stage play. There we go. F smash. Again, at side of stage. It's going to be a little too far for F smash, but that one is going to take it. And with Mario with a decent chunk of rage, might be able to, with a good combo or two, build up a decent amount of percent right now. Because with rage, all of your attacks are stronger and they deal more knockback. 40%. 48. I want to see a few more of those fireballs, because it makes it a lot tough. Fireball makes it a lot tougher for Piranha Plant to set up his traps and whatnot. Oh, that you cannot shield anymore against that, because that's going to break your shield and you're going to get punished for that hard. Very good with these back airs, punishing a lot of these charges on mid stage. I like the 2-frame attempt with the back air too. But the roll is going to get caught by Piranha Plant's F smash. 82% on Piranha Plant with two stocks. Can Lily secure the stock? Don't shield, don't shield. I actually, you know, in that situation, I would rather you take the damage. You do not want to get shield broken by Piranha Plant. And there's the shield break. You cannot shield up too much against Piranha Plant, or else you can rack up a lot of damage with the cloud. The cloud doesn't interrupt the stun from the shield break, so then you can just F smash you and build up a lot of percent. If Piranha Plant manages to get a shield break on you, he is one of the most likely to secure the kill in that situation. So really good cognizance coming out of that Piranha Plant player. So that puts Saginaw at 8 stocks, while Post is at 6. So with Piranha Plant as the starting character right now, who do you send in? Who do you send in against Piranha Plant? Piranha Plant is such an interesting character. I would probably send in K. Rool, to be honest. I feel like K. Rool would do a decent amount to really prevent Piranha Plant from kind of getting his setup going. If he's trying to do Patooie and Crown's interrupting him, or he's trying to set the cloud off, I think Crown does a lot against Piranha Plant, to be honest. So I would probably go to a stage like Smashville, Hollow Bastion. I would assume one of those is left open, because I think Piranha Plant also likes those stages. He probably likes being below a platform where he can kind of throw Patooie up. So there's probably a good chance that we do see Hollow Bastion or Smashville, I would say. Send in the K Rool. Come on, send in the K Rool. Do it. Yeah, we have the K Rool. So this is gonna be really cool. I think we're gonna see either Smashville or Hollow Bastion. Crown's gonna do so much work on the stage if it is. No, FD. Actually, I would say even better. You only have to worry about a single plane right now. You only have to worry about that one this one area for Crown to kind of, you know, go for. I think K. Rool is going to go into this really strong advantage. Because, exactly. And K. Rool's mobility isn't that bad. It is kind of bad, but it's not that bad, you know. I feel like it can do a decent amount against Piranha Plant. Though you don't want to get caught in those situations where he's charging down B and you're going to get punished with a blunderbuss. See a bit more ground. Oh, gonna catch that landing. Trying to 2-frame with the down B. Doing a decent amount to kind of get out of the range of Crown. nice dare to fair. That's actually a decent, interesting combo. But that neutral B, Patui, is going to steal the stock right now. Piranha Plant at 81%, though. Oh, F throw. Nice back away. That was the right move, but it was a little too soon. I think it was a little too soon on the down air. Might have been too late, though. It's hard to tell. It was so close. Right now, Piranha Plant's doing a decent job kind of being patient against K-Roll, trying to zone him out. Ooh, catching the jump with the down B. Oh, that's going to be a lot of percent when you're in that cloud. Well, that was a bit of a greedy F smash, but actually not a bad F smash. That's, oh my god, really good parry. Really good parry. Oh, that up smash is pretty disjointed. You can get caught in it, like just like that. Oh, where are you going? Oh, Blunt, yo, you're stuck in that. That was a quick 36%. jumping these K-Roll jumps with down B. I think that could have been an up air punish right there. That is one thing. You could use Reflector a bit more in this matchup. Probably work decent. Very good punish with that F with that fair. I probably want to see a few more approaches with Nair as well to mix up the side kind of approach up a little bit. Oh, I'm going to punish. Gonna go right through that crown. Nice reflector, but that can actually be punished at these percents. Oh, you could have. That was could have been a punish with Blunderbuss. Oh, reading the jump and gonna get it with the up smash. And this is putting Post down to their last three stocks. And Saginaw down to seven. I believe that was. I think that was Supersonic on K-Roll. Yes, it was. That was Supersonic. And this puts Desk down in kind of a similar position to where Post was last time, except now this is a four-stock deficit. So now Terry's got to do a lot of work if this is going to be Crimson Vexus next. Though, it's not, honestly, it's not unheard of for Terry to kind of steal stocks, especially against a character like Piranha Plant. Terry can do decent work. Piranha Plant's heavy, gets in on him, doesn't want to prevent him from even remotely setting up, though Patui can kind of punish Terry. It can be a tricky matchup in some regards. My cat is still chilling with me right here. That Yilo. And yeah, we get the Terry versus Piranha Plant. This is going to be Piranha Plant's last stock, so we're going to get to see a couple SDs right now. Does Piranha Plant keep his charge? I'm pretty sure. Does Piranha Plant keep his charge? No, he does not. Which is good. And here the match start. Terry's going right for the approach. These ledge situations are going to be the tricky part. And this is where Terry struggled in the previous set on these ledge situations. Nice shield. That's going to be a punish with down smash. Aggro? No. This Piranha Plant does like being aggro at ledge or rolling. Can also get a good decent punish on the jump with a decent up smash probably, or just even an up air. The main options are aggressive or wow. That was a, what percent was that? That wasn't that high. Hold on. What percent was that? Piranha Plant was... What was percent with Piranha Plant at? Oh, no, 91. Okay, that wasn't that bad. Okay, that F-Smash is going to take it, and that's going to put Saganaut down to 6 stocks. Well, Crimson has a nice, clean 3. So this is probably, you know, not a terrible position for Crimson Vexus to be in right now. Terry does have some matchups that Terry can, like, really kind of ride out pretty hard. He can be pretty oppressive on certain members of the cast. So, you know, there's not a, it's not a bad situation. I feel like if you get, like, a really good matchup, like, right here, then you can ride it into the next one, even if you just lose one stock. But this really is the situation where Terry needs to hold on to as many stocks as possible. He is a slightly heavier character. He's probably closer to medium weight than he is to heavyweight. But still, he's on the heavier side of the spectrum. He can live a little longer than most characters. So, this would be a good character to kind of be the anchor right now. Oh, and that's right. We had the Steve matchup before. So, now, we know that Crimson had a little bit of trouble with the minecart, though he was starting to find ways to interact with it and kind of stall out with, like, F-Smash and whatnot. Reading the jump, a nice up air. Oh, you can't air dodge through that. You cannot spot dodge through that jab. I'm going for fair. Not quite the spike, though. Oh, that's going to be a punish. Oh, F throw off stage. Yeah, these punishes are a little tough because Steve is going to walk backwards across the stage and try to kind of bait out your attack option and punch it comes after. You can always do the mix-up and not throw out the attack. But, jeez, that F-Smash almost killed. I can't believe that. At 110, Steve is kind of in a tough position, and up-smash is going to take it. With Terry at 72%, though, the stock is starting to get a little toasty. This will need a little bit more percent, though, to actually activate Go Meter. Oh, low-profiling the minecart. Nice high recovery. Oh, crack shooting right off stage is not a good time. Nice jump going right over the TNT. But minecart is going to punish that of landing. I think that F-Smash actually might have saved him, oddly enough. I think the knockback was really strange. Oh my god! Stealing that stock! Robbery with the Go Meter. Power Gazer is going to do amazing work. Wow. This is kind of crazy. This is very manageable right now. This could be a 3-stock because stuff like Terry's Power Gazer can steal stocks. Oh, but no, minecart is going to punish the landing right there, especially powered up with the redstone. Smash. Minecart. I like the Donkey Kong Country music, too. This is Donkey Kong Country 2, I think. Might be 1, though. I can't remember. So long ago. I like these F-Smashes on cart, to be honest. They're not that bad. Reading the... That F-Smash was a little greedy, but it worked out so well. Don't land on that. Wow. That was such kind of a tricky trap platform right there. Steve at 117. Oh, this stock. Wow. Down smash is a little weaker compared to Terry's other smashes, but it sends out a really weird angle. I can't tell if that was suspect DI or not, but either way, that side beat is going to take the stock, putting Crimson Vexus on just 2 stocks left. This is kind of impressive right now. That stock lead is pretty much gone, because now Saganaut is down to their last 3. It's only a 1 stock deficit for Post right now. Kind of similar showing to what we had in the previous match. Could this be another reversal, and then Post cleans it up 2-0? Jeez. Jeez. Though we're probably going to get Pyromithra at this point, which could be a little bit of a trouble for Terry, though I feel like they're neutral. You know, Pyromithra neutral versus Terry's neutral. I think Terry does compete well, just like I said at the start. I think he does compete well in this matchup, and he can't exploit some of Pyramithra's weaknesses. I think it's probably an even matchup, to be honest, because I think Terry is probably a little better off stage than Pyramithra. I don't know about that. Now that I'm thinking about it, I might regret saying that. It's tough. It really is tough because they can probably exploit each other in very, like, oppressive ways off stage. They probably can. It's just how it is. I might give the matchup in Pyramithra's favor a bit. Or we might see a character switch. You know, very well could. Maybe we'll get, like, a Terry counter. Like Game & Watch or something. Game & Watch probably does really good against the FGC characters. If we are playing on Hollow Bastion or Smashville, that's going to probably be a bit better stage for Pyramithra. We're going to get Sora. Oh, damn. Wow. I don't even know what this matchup is going to be like. Oh, my God. Because these characters, you know, Sora has a disjoint, and he wants to kind of work on... Both of these characters want to, like, kind of pressure your shield in different ways. Sora has a disjoint, though. But Sora's mobility isn't as, you know, universal as Terry's in a lot of ways. And that's going to get punished. Oh, no. Very good side B, kind of going off to the ledge. Sora probably has an easier time falling out of Terry's combos due to his lightness and his floaty nature. But, oh, the SD. Wow, only 20% on Crimson Vex's. Crimson must be feeling really good. Really nice string with those Nair loops. It wasn't a Nair loop, but, you know, those Nair strings. Up smash, not going to be able to get punished. Freeze is such a good spell for Sora. Did he just power... That should have been a confirm. I don't know how he powered through that with up B. That's crazy. That's going to get punished. No! That was... almost a good kill confirm right there. Very nice dash attack. You do not want to be sending out Thundaga in neutral like that. It is a Thundaga is kind of an inconsistent move. The hitboxes on it are not that great. You kind of only want to use it in, like, when your opponent's off stage generally. Oh, but now we're gonna see Crimson Vex is down to his last stock right now. Saginaw's at 2. Posted at 1. Crimson needs to secure this stock right now. Oh, there's going to be a lot of damage on Sora right now, though. Crimson Vex is at 55, and Sora can kind of recover wherever he wants. And that's going to be it. Sora's kind of light. Crimson Vex is at 58%. He needs to hold on to as much low percent situations as he can. Good shield. Gonna be a punish with jab, jab. Oh, going right in for the jab. I actually did like that. Going for the power dunk off stage there could be a risky move, especially against a character like Sora, who can kind of, like, go off stage just pretty much as much as he wants. Really nice follow-up on the dash attack. I like that tech situation. No side B is gonna put Terry at 97%. Not quite enough for Go Meter. Now Go Meter's online. And this is the point... Oh. We could see a steal right here because Sora is a very light character. One Power Gazer could seal out the stock at this point. You gotta get off that platform. Get below Sora. You do not want to be above Sora. Back throw might kill. Back throw's gonna kill. Back throw's gonna kill. Back throw's gonna kill. Yep. Back throw is going to kill. And we are going to see the stocks even out right now. Really close showing. Really good stuff coming out of Saginaw right now. So now it is 1-1, and we get another reset. So now, stocks reset back to 9-9. We get a little bit more of that, you know, smash action. And again, we start again the next round with the starter stages. So we're going to see Battlefield, Final Destination, Town and City, Pokemon Stadium 2, or Smashville. And this is going to be the last set of everybody. This set right here is going to be the final one. This is a best of three. Now, if I'm post, I don't know who to send out. I feel like both lineups have been working pretty decently for post. You could really, like, mix it up if you wanted to and send Terry out first. But I don't know. I think Crimson Vexes have been doing a really good job as an anchor. Might want to keep him there. I did like the Mario start, to be honest. I did like that. I did like Lily kind of being the starter. And if that's the case, go for something like Battlefield. Jeez. Or you can, you know, send me in. I'll take care of him. I can take it. I can do it. Send me in, everybody. I got this. It looks like we do have some sort of stage selected. What it is, we're gonna find out. Jeez. Who would win? A sad boy or an eagle? I like to think that Mr. Saturn is the sad boy. Ready? Mario versus Aegis. Now this is probably, it's kind of a tough one for Mario. Mario doesn't like disjoints, bro. I think we actually saw this one. This was the second match of the second game of the first set, I think. So let's see if Lily can kind of adapt a little bit more, because I know Lily in the first set of games didn't come out on top on this one. Lightning Buster isn't going far enough to get that. Not able to punish the side B. I like how Mario's trying to keep a bubble kind of away from Pyramithra right now. That's kind of what you want to do, and then punish those items right there. Mithra has no right having something like Foresight. Foresight is so annoying. Rolling back into that side B into Blazing End is going to be, you know, a little tough. Blazing End is so offensive. Mario 96, 109. This is prime real estate for Pyra right now. Punishing the approach, that is a really good anti-air move. Prominence Revolt will do wonders, snuffing out your jumps. Photon Edge. Gonna punish the landing with Jab. Nice low recoveries. Crossing up with the... Punishing with that F throw. Just gonna jab it out. Jab it out for days. Lightning Bust is gonna send Mario right back off stage, though. Wow. So many of these approaches are getting just snuffed out with all of these disjoints. When you approach a character like Pyra or Mithra, you need to be very careful. I would like to see a lot of full hop fireball on these approaches. Mario has the benefit of having projectile that he can kind of run up behind. So a lot of these approaches could be a little easier with the full hop fireball, and Mario just runs behind it and kind of punishes whatever Pyra Mithra decides to do against it. But right now, Lily at their last stock, 75% on Mithra, 94 off stage. Not able to punish the jump. Up smash is going to get punished on Mario. These up smashes are a little shallow. Not able to secure these stocks. That could have been a punish. He could have grabbed and then back thrown. That roll is going to get punished by Prominence Revolt. Mario's at 59% off stage. Blazing in. So this Pyra Mithra really likes throwing out an attack and then dashing back. So it's going to put, when Mario kind of throws out some sort of aggressive option, it is going to get punished because, dash back is a very strong tool in this game. And that's going to bring Post down to 6 stocks. So in those situations, if your opponent is throwing out an attack and rolling backwards or dashing back to try and bait out your aggressive option because they know you can't punish, then what you generally want to do is just reset neutral. You're going to be a lot better off for it, or you just kind of read the roll and kind of run at the roll. Extend a little bit more of what you think is going to happen. Me, though, I'm kind of a person, I like resetting neutral a lot. Resetting neutral isn't the best option against certain characters, but when they're so hard to punish, like Pyra and Mithra, I would say resetting neutral and just, backing off a little bit can do wonders. Because now you've gotten back to that basic even on even footing. And now you have stage control because your opponent just dashed away back to the other side of the stage. You have them cornered now. You can wait out a little bit and see what they do after the fact. Because what happens? They rolled a stage. Now they're in the corner. They got to get out of the corner somehow because they don't have any more room to dash back. So they can go off stage, I guess, if they wanted to. But now they're off stage. They don't want to be there. So sometimes you're just better off waiting it out, keeping them cornered, and just standing there. And sometimes just even standing there can be an oppressive presence to your opponent. But against Pyra Mithra, bring him to a triplat, I guess. They probably still do really well. Pyra probably does decently well on triplats. I would just not bring them to Smashville. I wouldn't bring them to Hollow Bastion. Definitely don't give them a kitty. They do really well against kitties. You might want to send out Crimson Vexus early in this kind of situation, to be honest. You might want to send Crimson Vexus out. But we're going to get K-Rool. Now, this is going to be a little tough, I would say, on... This is going to be Sonic Atom, I assume. No, Super Sonic. This is Super Sonic. So, K-Rool is combo food against Mithra. It's tough. It's a tough matchup for K-Rool. And then Pyra can send outside me to contest a lot of situations. That crown pit is going to do a decent amount of damage, though. Follow-ups on back crown hit. The turnaround. Ooh. I always hate it when you turn around accidentally. It's like my least favorite thing to do in this game. Trying to read the jump with neutral B. I'd like to see a bit more rising fair for those kind of jump reads. Down throw into jab. I actually like it, but the jab 3 came out a little too late. Not able to get the full punish. Blazing End is going to do some work. With K-Rool to be such a big body, Blazing End is going to do so much work in this matchup. Another Blazing End. Yep. This Pyromithra definitely loves dashing back. God, and it's going to clank with Crown. That is so oppressive. Oh, Down Smash is going to get punished by Photon Edge. Lightning Buster. Oh, can you make it up with it? That's a re-grab, though. You can get punished for that. Nice. Let's grab. Up throw is not going to be strong enough to take it yet. Get in there, though. Soon. Soon it'll be good to kill. I really like that cannonball to punish Promise Revolt. God, that dash attack is so big. K-Rool just can't get away. Prominence Revolt is so strong. Gonna catch him in the air. Oh my god. With Pyromithra at 135, Mithra being a little lighter, the kill is gonna get secured with that back air. Oh, that's gonna get punished. That could have been a Nair as soon as that back hit came out. A Nair or a Dare probably would have worked there. Nice. Punish. That was wonderful. Oh, that they held onto their jump. That was such a good punish, though. I loved the idea of that. Well, Blazing End is going to punish a lot of these landings, especially against Blunderbuss. Oh, and the Belly Armor is coming in clutch in those situations. There's no jump right there. So, in that situation, Pyra either needs to recover low or recover high. Holding onto that jump. So I would have liked to have seen some sort of contest off stage at that point, which he burned her jump. Oh, this is gonna be a dash attack. Yep. Gonna punish the landing. And we're gonna see Promise Revolt. Nope, side B. Promise Revolt probably gonna punish this up. Oh. Hold on. Yeah, there's the Promise Revolt. Back throw. Yep, back throw right back off stage. Oh, that up tilt. Up tilt's gonna punish the back hit. Ooh. This is so tough. Let's see if Supersonic can secure this last kill. Oh my god. That's gonna punish the jump. Dash attack. You dared. Up air. Very good confirm. Really good stuff coming out of Supersonic right now. Blazing End's gonna punish Crown. Blazing End can punish so many moves. It's such a versatile move. Nair not quite strong enough to kill. Really good Belly Armor, but the turnaround. Ooh, they're gonna get punished by the up tilt. Really good stuff coming out of Supersonic. Bringing Post down to their last three stocks. And Saginaw down to 7. So this is a similar position to what we found ourselves in the previous set. So let's see if Crimson Vexus can do it again. Can go right for the 7 stocks, turnaround. I don't know if you guys could hear that. It was my cat purring right into the mic. We have Crimson Vexus coming up for the anchor again. I assume, though maybe we could see... maybe we're going to see Lone Wolf. Maybe we will see Lone Wolf. That'd be good too. Ooh. Let's see who we decide to go. Fly, Eagles, fly. You can fly too, Eagles, too. And we are getting Crimson Vexus for our final post-U player. And this is it. No more players for post-U. So you got to hold on to these stocks as long as you can. Now, Crimson Vexus, very strong anchor. I have faith. I think he can do it. We got a couple SDs coming out of Pyramitha right now. Come on, come on! Do it. Go. Jab into side B. Down tilt for the tech situation, but not able to get the punish. Dash attack is... Ooh, punishing the dash attack. Prominence revolt in neutral. Jeez. Trying to read the air dodge with an up smash, but air dodging to the right instead. Up air is going to intersect. Up smash. Trying to punish a landing with the F smash, but not getting the correct read at that point. And Terry's at 87%. Oh, both characters at 87%. Keeping this pretty even. Jeez. No. Go meters online. Oh my god! Prominence Revolt is so big. That attack is unreal, dude. I can't believe it killed from that far. But Power Dunk is going to take it. But that was such a necessary stock for Saginaw right there. That one stock on Crimson was so crucial to take from him. Bringing Post down to 2. And Saginaw down to 6. Now, here's the tough part. Now it's essentially got to be 2-3 stocks coming out of, you know, coming out of Crimson right now. Crimson has to do 2-3 stocks pretty much to secure this win. That one stock was so important because you generally want at least another buffer stock between, you know, the two players. It was kind of imperative that he holds on to it. You know, percent of change. The one stock on Crimson Vexus is worth a lot more now than the one stock on Saginaw. So now it's that much tougher for Crimson Vexus to pull off this reversal. Prominence Revolt is way too big. It is way too big. We gotta nerf it. Oh wait, we can't nerf it. This game is done being patched. I always wonder if we're gonna get like an updated version of this game though. Like if we're gonna see like the ultimate collection, or like, you know, kind of like Street Fighter 2, like a turbo, like those ultimate editions for Street Fighter or something. I wonder if we would ever get one of those for Smash. This would be the one to do it. Where it's like some things change. I would love it if they did that for this game. Or maybe we're just gonna get like a Smash 5. I mean Smash 6. Maybe we'll just get Smash 6. I am going to guess we're going to see Piranha Plant. Piranha Plant is coming out now. Yeah. He's a sad boy. Captain Falcon. Oh my god. Wow. I think Terry probably does pretty decent in this matchup. I think Terry probably has a little bit of an edge on Captain Falcon. Captain Falcon's recovery is not the greatest, and I feel like Terry can probably exploit it. Though, honestly, it's probably even. It's probably even, though. The one benefit that Terry is going to have more consistent smaller combos, I would say. Punishing a lot of these landings, though. Oh, that's going to get punished on shield. These nairs are doing pretty good work against Captain Falcon right now. Punishing the neutral air dodge! Well, the fastfall air dodge, rather, with that up smash. Really good cognizance coming out of Crimson. A lot of nair pressure. I love it. I love nair pressure. So strong in this game. F-tilt off stage. Oh, that. Oh, my God. I saw that coming a mile away. Oh, reading the jump. You want to hold on to as many of your resources as possible. Gonna contest a lot of these strings from Captain Falcon with those nairs. Catching the landing with up smash, as always. Up air. Going for a lot of these juggles. Power dunk. Oh my god. Captain Falcon is spending a lot of time above Terry. And you don't want to do that. Terry's going to punish you. If he can read where you're going to land, oh man, Terry can get so much off of that. I actually like that turnaround right there. Getting away with the power dunk. So Terry's at 88%. This is looking really tough for Terry right now. Can Crimson secure this last stock? Oh my god, really crucial power dunk right there. Because you do not want to get up smashed by Captain Falcon at these percents. Oh, really good confirm. I like the crack shoot off stage to kind of like... It's a little harder to punish. Oh, that F-tilt. We're going to... Really risky moves, Crimson. Really risky moves. He's going to catch that out of shield. Oh my god. And Ani is going to take it. And that's it for Post University. The game goes to Saginaw. Really strong showing coming out of Saginaw. Wow, really strong. I will say, really strong showing coming out of Post tonight as well. Like, really, that was so strong. But Saginaw is going to take it 2-1 over Post. Really good showing coming out of everybody tonight. Especially with Crimson, really good job being the anchor tonight, able to secure a large quantity of stocks at the end to kind of come back from these deficits. But I will say, with every match, I can see everybody improving. I can see like those little bits of detail coming out of everybody tonight, and like, you know, their little improvements on their gameplay and their general neutral. It's awesome to see. Really good showing coming out of everybody tonight. But thank you all. I have been Frisco, and this has been Post Orange versus Saginaw Valley. Thank you guys for joining me today, and we will see you guys next time. Tomorrow, what do we have tomorrow? Tomorrow we have Smash Orange versus Holy Cross at 7 p.m. We're also supposed to have Smash Purple tomorrow against Fisher College at 8, but I believe that is being... Oh no, Holy Cross is forfeiting tomorrow. So tomorrow at 8 o'clock p.m. we have Smash Purple versus Fisher College. So again, 8 o'clock tomorrow night, we have Smash Purple versus Fisher College. And then Thursday, we have Halo Infinite versus St. Mary's College at 8 p.m. And I'll be casting them. So I'm excited to see everybody there. And thank you guys for joining me. And we will see you guys next time. Adios.